What is going on, everyone? It is Angel coming back at you with another awesome review. And today we got Miguel O'Hara, aka Spider-Man 2099, my hands down favorite version of Spider-Man, leading this video, we could say. But yeah, man, I got something that I'm pretty excited for. Let's go ahead and pull it out. It is the Dragon Ball Z Son Goku Legendary Super Saiyan. Or Super Saiyan Son Goku. I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. I gotta catch up on my DBZ. Obviously, this is a very older episode. But, you know, ironically enough, I got into Dragon Ball because of action figures. I didn't really get into it because I watched it as a kid. I got into it through toys and actually the video game, which I had on my GameCube. But, here is the box, man. This definitely looks nice. I don't know if it's $70 nice, though. Because that's what I paid for it. And that is pretty much retail. But it does look pretty cool. I haven't had a Dragon Ball Z figure in a while. But I love when Goku goes Super Saiyan with the ripped up clothing. It just looks super fun and super exciting. Let's go ahead and crack this open and get into the review. Well, that spilled everywhere. Tons of those little blast effects. Well, not blast effects, but you put it together. Got a blast effect here. Whole bunch of hands. Holy crap. This is definitely my favorite face here. That is really cool. Very angry. Obviously, Goku himself, which I have to say, it feels very nice. It's just like, it looks good, but it feels like it's missing something. If that makes sense. All right, so here we have the SH Figure Arts Super Saiyan Son Goku out of the box. And you're probably wondering why I have him posed up like this. I mean, obviously he's going super crazy Super Saiyan mode, but the only reason I have him posed up kind of slouched like this is because I had a really hard time standing him up. But, first impressions is he's definitely very smooth, very buttery, and he came out of the package, you know, very, very nice to pose, and I like that a lot. It's definitely a good figure, and I've come to expect SH Figure Arts making great Dragon Ball Z figures. You know, we all have, but it's not anything that kind of surprised me. Like, I knew what to expect, if that makes sense. It is a new body buck for Goku, so that's very exciting. And I do think it looks really good. But let's run through his accessories really quick. That way you can see what's going on here. He's got another headpiece. I can get the camera to focus. That comes with, you know, the hairpiece that you can attach to it, which would look like that. And then another one, which I will take this off real quick to show you. That looks like this. So, you know. And then a crap ton of hands, obviously. He comes with these open kind of Kamehameha. I don't want to say it wrong because I'm scared of you intense Dragon Ball Z fans. And then another one, kind of like more angry. And then obviously, you know, fighting stance, hands look great. Whoops. Love that there's lots of hands so you can get tons of awesome photos and poses. And then very similar to the Kamehameha, but they have little stub on them. That way you can put on the awesome blast effect, which is actually very nicely painted. Has some good shading on it. Ah, just keep dropping stuff. And then, yeah, you just put it in the hand, and then there you go. So here's the figure, man. It looks pretty awesome. Take this left hand off. Pops off very easy. Just take that blast effect, put it in the pig. There you go. And now you got Goku doing his awesome Kamehameha effect. Which looks freaking awesome, I have to say. Super cool. I love that a lot. You can definitely play with it and make it look a lot better than what I got going on. But yeah, figure itself, this guy definitely looks really cool. I love the way he moves, man. Great articulation as always. But here's a little up close and personal. Head to toe. Turn down my brightness a little bit. And yeah, you can see that they put a lot of emphasis in the anime aesthetic with the huge freaking giant shoulders and the just the V waist. Looks great. The only gripe I have with the aesthetic is the way his rib cage is curved like that with those pointy ribs, kind of. It looks a little strange, but I can get past it. Everything else is pretty good. He's kind of pointy, so like playing around with him is fun, but it feels like I'm gonna get, you know, I'm getting poked a lot. It doesn't, like, it's not dangerous or anything, but I'm definitely getting poked. Yeah, really cool. I wish they added a lot of like shading. It just kind of looks like a plain plastic peach or, you know, white skin color. Love this face, though. This has to be my favorite out of all the faces here. And I love how the hair is shaded, which looks really good. And the pants are shaded as well. So, yeah, that's cool. He comes with multiple faces. He comes with this one, which is like a, you know, kind of cocky, angry face. And then this one's just really cocky. He knows he's going to win. And then last but not least, just like a smug, you know, angry, let's get this over with kind of face. But obviously, out of all of them, this is the one that I'm going to leave on because it's just so sick. I love the way he looks pissed off. Let's run through the articulation. Looks up fantastic. Looks down fantastic. There's a joint in the upper neck and the lower neck. Oh, popped off. At least you can see how the face goes on. Pretty simple. I'll just take another face like this smirk one and show you real quick. Just pop it on the lower peg things. Whatever. I guess I'll take this one back. But yeah, you just pop it in there and pretty easy to go. Yeah, and then the shoulders, they go up very high. You know, they got the butterfly joint, so you can reach across pretty well. Rotation at the upper bicep, double-jointed pinless elbows, rotation at the wrist, forward and backward. Very, very nice ab crunch. Can go back pretty well, too. Legs can go up super-duper high because this crotch piece, though it gets in the way and moves around a lot, it's soft and I'm not really annoyed by it or anything. Splits, no problem. Legs go back too. And then, yeah, he can do that with his knees, double jointed pinless knees. You know, very cool flight poses for his flying around and all that. And yeah. And then, ankle rocker forward and backwards, and then this nice bend at the toe. But yeah, everything else is fantastic. I would say the way he moves is awesome, but it's something that we've come to expect from SH Figure Arts. They know how to make a figure articulate. What they really need to do is learn how to freaking shade and add some details, because this guy is loaded with scratches and all that, but you know, I want to see a little bit of blood or a little bit of dirt, you know, like he just looks too clean. And yeah, you know, we got to get that battle effect. Let's go ahead and do some size comparisons and get him next to some figures. All right, so there's Goku looking nice, and I got the Figma Metroid Dread Samus, which actually sizes up, I guess, not that decent. I don't know what height Goku is supposed to be, but he's obviously pretty small. We got the Jada Toys Evil Ryu on the left. And then we got Marvel Legends Deadpool. And then last but not least, SH Figuarts Broly. And the crazy part is, this dude's $99.99. And look at all the shading on his upper torso. This guy's $67.99. 20 bucks. It's not that big of a difference. Give us some shading on that torso. Like, bring out the scars. Like, you could see the scar on his chest. Bring out those scars and those scratches, man. Otherwise, that figure would be like almost a 10 out of 10 if it had those scratches and those little bloody spots. I don't think SH Figure Arts is going to give that to us, but maybe in the future. Yeah, so honestly, guys, at the end of the day, this is a great Goku figure. Possibly the best. A lot of other people are saying it's the best Goku. And I can see why, but from prior experience with SH Figure Arts, they have always been killing it with their Dragon Ball Z stuff. I just feel like they didn't add enough to this figure. I wish they would have shaded him up a bit, you know, just gave him a little bit more detail. But I do like that it comes with a bunch of hands and a bunch of those faces and then his blast effect. So it does have a nice amount of accessories. And I do think he has a great amount of articulation. This guy's fun. But do I think he is a 10 out of 10 figure? Not really. I'm going to go ahead and give him an 8.9 out of 10. I think he's a great figure, but he just doesn't have that wow factor that I was expecting. He doesn't feel like anything that new to me. And yeah, if they would have added some more shading on him with the scars and all that, maybe a little bit of some blood effects. I don't think they can do that, or I don't think they will do that, but this figure would have been a solid possible 10. Regardless, yeah, he's a great Dragon Ball Z Super Saiyan Son Goku. And if you're on the hunt for that, I definitely do recommend it if you're a big Dragon Ball Z fan. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoy my content, I try to upload 1 to 2 times a month with the reviews. And then I do a bunch of shorts here and there with posing figures, reviewing figures, and just, you know, some cool shorts here and there for the YouTube and my social media community. I will leave my IG down below. Please follow that. And I post a lot of cool action figure stuff on there. And I'll also leave my TikTok down below, which I also do some more action figure stuff on there as well. But thank you guys so much. Have an amazing day. And thanks for watching. Peace.